Alright. Ready to get back into the Word. Here we are in the Gospel of John. Left off at chapter 1, verse 14. And here we are starting verse 15. John the Baptist bear witness of him, Yeshua, and cried, saying, now this bear witness is in the Greek, is an interesting word. It is matura, where we get our word mature, where we get our word gospel, where we get our word martyr from. So, are you mature? Do you bear witness? John bear witness of him and cried, saying, this was he of whom I spake. He that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. He that cometh after me is preferred before me. That is actually, in the Greek, it is not preferred, it's he was, he actually existed before him. As Yeshua did, existed in time at the beginning of the creation with the Yahweh. Come before me, was before me. Heard of it before in the fullness of time. Okay, 16. And of his fullness have all received in grace for grace. And the text read, for his fullness. Instead of for, over, against his entire, against his forms. For. No, I got that wrong. I'm sorry, that's the next four. The text read four. His fullness instead of and pleroma his fullness the evangelist speaks here, John, the writer of the gospel. Speaks here, not John the Baptist, but John, the friend of Yeshua, speaks here of the ever-fresh grace according to the need, grace for grace. New grace, continuous and unintermitted grace. There was grace in the days of Moses, grace and truth, but the law itself was the exhibition of truth. But when Yeshua Messiah came, he himself was the truth, the very personification of truth. And his life and death were the supreme manifestation of grace. and of his fullness have all we received in grace for grace. The law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Yeshua Messiah. Because he was, he actually is, grace and truth, which is a Hebraism, which means divine revelation. Continuous and unintermittent. Verse 18, no man has seen Yahweh at any time, the only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him. No human eye, Odysseus in Greek, no human eye, a compound of U, have seen this word Horeo in Greek. Christ, the only begotten. He who is like and was. Isis unto. In the beginning. He hath declared as revealed, which is exegeomai, to lead, to wake, make way, to make known by expounding. Hence the English word exegesis. So when you use exegesis, you're expounding upon the word, just as John the Baptist did, by declaring Yeshua. To reveal means literally to exegeomai, to lead, to reveal, to make known. Expounded. Verse 19, and this is the record of John. Of John, the writer of this gospel. And also of John the Baptist. Not that he wrote this gospel. This is the record of his witness, his mature eye, his martyrdom. And this is the record of John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask, who art thou? The word record here is mature eye once again. Jews. And the Jews is actually a word that refers to them, a name given them by the Gentiles. Because and they became Lo Ami, which means not my people. They are not Israel. The Jews at that time became Lo Ami, not Israel. They still are not Israel, the Jews. And the word Jews was actually a term given them by Gentiles. And it's a derogatory term, actually.